So how effective is chemotherapy really? The contribution of chemo to a 5-year survival rate in adults, in one report, which I'm going to put a link down below, in Australia, it's only 2.3%. And if you live in the US, it's only 2.1%. Now, what does that mean? It means that if you had a group of people who took chemo, at the end of 5 years, only 2.1% of them would still be alive. The rest would be dead. Now, what I'm going to tell you is not meant to replace your medical care. Check with your doctor before taking any advice. I'm not telling you in this video not to do chemo. I'm just giving you information that I suggest that you need to research. There's two really important definitions that I want to talk about. One is relative risk, and the other is absolute risk. When you're being told the effectiveness of a drug or some treatment, you really don't want to know the relative risk. You want to know the absolute risk. Let's say, for example, before chemo, it was found that 2 people out of 100 die. And after chemo, 1 out of 100 would die. What would the relative risk look like? Well, it would look like this. Chemo decreases cancer mortality rate by 50%. If you take the chemo, you'll have more than a 2x chance of surviving for 5 years. So chemo will double your rate of survival. That sounds very hopeful, doesn't it? Let's take a look at what it actually means. Now, if we take a look at these numbers, okay, and if we look at the absolute risk, it gives a different picture. Chemo decreases cancer mortality rate by 1%, okay, because we're going from 2 to 1. Remember, these are fractions, they're not whole numbers. So, drug companies and certain people that want to make their study look way better than it really is will always talk about relative risks, okay? And they won't mention this right here. If you have cancer and you're presented with chemo, the only thing you want to know is how long will it prolong your life? Right here. That's what you need to find out. So you ask your doctor, if I take this chemo, how much longer am I going to live? That's what you need to know. And then after they tell you, you want to request a study and actually read it yourself to see if it matches up. So we have two problems. Number one, we want to know what their definition of effectiveness is. And number two, we want to know how safe it is, because chemo is a poison. Because if it barely gives you any results, and at the same time it's adding some major toxicity, you want to really weigh out your choices. Now, the other thing that I would do if I was talking to an oncologist is I would want to know if they are open to alternative therapy or natural type things, because there is some significant science behind using natural things to affect cancer. And you just want to know if they're open to it. And if they're open to it, great. If they're not, all that tells you is they have a fixed idea and they're unwilling to look at the information that's out there. And the last thing I want to mention is if you haven't seen my interview with Dr. Seyfried on cancer, I think you'll find it very interesting. Check it out. I put it up right here.